Thank you. Hallelujah. How are you guys tonight? All right. Well, man, I just do so much traveling. They tell me I was here 2 years ago, and I can't remember it. God, it's terrible. But tonight, I have brought a couple of special people along to help me remember. My daughter, Charity, is here. Where are you, Charity? There she is, the sweet little girl right there. And my son, Daniel, is here. I think he's over there taking care of things for me. And so it's good to see everyone here tonight. We've been traveling through blizzards and ice storms now for 3 weeks, and everyone says, oh, I'm sorry, we couldn't make it out tonight. Oh, so it's good to see a lot of people, and so glad you're here. So, yes, I am. I'm Ted Pearce, and I hope that's enough. So, all right. So, I'm just curious: is there how many people here have never been in a Messianic congregation before? Anyone? All right, cool. Then I don't have to explain who Yeshua. Oh, there was somebody. All right. Well, thanks for coming. Glad to see that you made it tonight. You're the special guest. We're gonna let you handle the snakes first. So it's just a joke. I'm sorry. It's a bad joke. Anyways, I'd just like to find that out because I'll be saying Yeshua in place of Jesus tonight. It's the same son of Joseph and Mary from Nazareth. But I like to say Yeshua because that's what his mama called him. But it's also a Hebrew word still in use today. Yeshua means salvation in the present tense. And he is still salvation in the present tense for us tonight. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. So I like to start just by mentioning that I'm not Jewish. A lot of people think I am. Maybe it's the hat. I'm not sure. I wear the hat because... Well, my wife cuts my hair. But I got her permission to say that, okay? So anyway, she's a wonderful lady. Make sure I say that. I was an atheist playing in a rock and roll band. I started playing professionally when I was 15. Yeah, go ahead and have a seat. Started playing professionally when I was 15 years old. When I was 29 years old, I was playing in a band, had just been nominated for Best Rock Band in Dallas, and I was buying a car at this car lot on a Friday afternoon when the owner came out, and he was a Seventh-day Adventist, and he says to me, listen, you need to hurry up and make your choice because we're going to close for the Sabbath. And I'm not sure why an atheist would care, but I got into an argument with him. I said, oh, come on, man, even an atheist knows the Sabbath is on Sunday. And he made me so angry that I decided I was just going to prove that he was wrong. And so I went and got a Bible. We were playing at a Holiday Inn, and they had them in the drawer. And I took that Bible, and I started studying it. And for 4 months, I was obsessive about finding all the stuff that was wrong in it that I was just sure was wrong. Well, I guess you see how that worked out. Hallelujah. So anyway, I don't mind making people mad if it'll make them try to prove me wrong. But anyway, that's what happened to me. And I started reading the Bible. And I mean, I was really studying it hard. And you know, the only theology I knew came from the book of Jeremiah, where God says, when you seek me with your whole heart, you will find me. And after 4 months of not being able to prove there was anything wrong with this Bible, I decided I really could trust it. And I was driving home one night from a gig in my little Datsun B210, thinking about all the stuff that I had been reading. And I just looked up in the sky and I said, okay, God, Jesus, whoever you are, if you're the one connected to this book, then I would follow you. But you're going to have to prove it. Have you ever shaken your finger at God? I don't think it scares him one bit. And I don't really recommend it if you're driving, because suddenly the rest of me started shaking with my hand. Oh, this had never happened before. And this is where I said my first real prayer. Okay, God, maybe not so much at once. And I stopped shaking. And then when I got home, I opened up that Bible, only now I started reading all those red ink parts I'd been skipping over. You know, I think atheists know there's a God, or I wouldn't have been afraid of those red ink parts. But as I started reading the red ink parts, well, I saw two things. Number one, Jesus was nothing like what I thought he was. And I was really ashamed of myself for having gone 29 years of my life letting other people tell me who he was. For something as important as your eternal soul, it would seem like you'd want to know the truth, you know? And so if you're in this room tonight and you don't absolutely love this one we call Jesus, Yeshua, then I say, you've never met him. I didn't want to love him. It messed up everything in my rock and roll band. But I could not resist when I met him. So, you know, if you'd like to know him, there's a lot of nice people here who could help you, but why not go right to the source? Why not let him tell you who he is? We carry Bibles with us now everywhere we go, just so we can have them if somebody needs to know. So if you if you want to meet him tonight, man, we'd love to help you. But the second thing I noticed as I read this New Testament for the first time, all these people are Jews. They don't tell you that in Vidor, Texas. I mean, I thought, you know, Peter was the Pope and Mary was a Catholic and John was a Baptist and Paul was a Pentecostal, and they're all Jews. And I begin wondering what happened to them. I mean, why is it Jews are here and Christians are there and they're not the same thing anymore? Because in the Bible, they were all Jews. Wow. And so I started randomly calling churches and asking them things about, like, you know, why Sunday? Why not the Sabbath? What do you have a lot of Jews there? And why not? And I even called a synagogue and asked if they believed in Jesus. They just hung up on me. But I really didn't know what I was doing, but I knew I had read this Bible and I knew I could trust it, you know? So finally, somebody told me about a place called Baruch Hashem in Dallas, Texas, and Rabbi Marty Waldman and our cantors, Jeff Seif, and both of them are children of Holocaust survivors. And I walked into this place, and they're blowing these long tube things. I'd never seen that as a professional musician. I didn't know what that was, but they're playing tambourines and dancing and singing and clapping and having more fun than any of the bars I was playing at. And so the Lord had been showing me as I was reading the Bible that he had a heavy burden for his people. I mean, for their entire history, the Jewish people were in rebellion. It seems like just every once in a while, it'd be a big deal that somebody wasn't in rebellion. And yet he was constantly calling them back, constantly calling them back. And Yeshua even wept over the city, you know. And I could just feel that burden he has for his chosen people to return to him. And as I entered into this messianic congregation, I really entered into the suffering of the Jewish people, especially being taught the Bible by two Holocaust survivors. And so it was in the January 15th, 1990, I got saved in my little Datsun B210. And really within only a couple of weeks, I had entered into the messianic community. And you know, back then there weren't a whole lot of people writing songs for Jewish people that believe in Jesus. So I started, you know, writing songs just for our little music team. And over the years, more and more congregations began to grow up and many churches began to become interested. And before you know it, I'm starting to travel a lot and play a lot of places. And I go wherever I'm invited, and it's brought me here tonight, and I'm really glad about that. Hallelujah. And one more thing is, a lot of people don't know it, but I'm actually an ordained German pastor. Yeah. I'm ordained through a church in Tübingen, Germany. Yo, dog, I'm a German shepherd. So you got, what you got is an old Texas redneck that plays Jewish music and is an ordained German shepherd. I don't think a platypus is that mixed up. So anyways, I used to travel with my two oldest boys, but both of them got married, and hallelujah, I have a grandbaby now. Yeah. And it's true, grandbabies really are cool. So so now I'm using the Amazing Invisible Economy Band again tonight, and I call him Mac. It's kind of like karaoke. Okay, it's karaoke. But I did at least write or co-write all the songs, and I produced them, and I hired the musicians, and then I didn't, you know, put them on here so I don't have to pay them anymore. So this first song I'm going to start with is called Shalom. We wish you the blessing of Shalom. And it really was written with a friend of mine in a hospital room in Germany. We wanted to write a song that people could meet and greet each other with. And so as I play this song, I want you to, you know, feel free to schmooze. I know you guys, it's going to be hard to get you back in your seats once we finish. I can just tell. But feel free to schmooze. And just tell everyone that they're welcome here tonight, and this is a good place to be. And if you see anyone sitting with a frown on their face, well, bless them twice, okay? And we're going to have a good time rejoicing tonight. Is that all right? All right, hallelujah. Well, let me give Mac a kickstart. Let the schmoozing begin. Shalom. Shalom. La 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 la. Shalom, shalom. We wish you the blessing of shalom, shalom, shalom. Sha 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 sha. It's of Yeshua. Shalom, shalom. We wish you the blessing of shalom, shalom, shalom. Sha, 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 shalom. Shalom, everyone. This blessing unto you, special kind of peace, like kind you might have heard about. Oh, there might be even war, but in the presence of the Lord, there is hope in every situation. Shalom, shalom. We wish you the blessing of shalom, shalom, shalom. Sha, 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 shalom. To be here tonight, isn't it? Oh, shalom, shalom. We wish you the blessing of shalom, shalom, shalom. Sha, sha, shalom, shalom. Oh, we wish you the blessing of shalom, shalom, shalom. Sha, 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 shalom. Lord, we ask you to just let your shalom fall on us tonight. Bring wholeness and healing, restoration, prosperity. La, 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 la. Shalom, 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 shalom. The very peace of God. La, 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 la. Oh, shalom, shalom. Oh, we wish you the blessing.
song of shalom, 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 sha, sha, shalom, shalom. Oh, we wish you the blessing of shalom, 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 sha, 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 shalom. La 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 la. Hey, on the count of two, let's all shout shalom at each other. Are you ready? Here we go. One, two, shalom!
So this next song is a very simple Hebrew phrase. It means, behold, our Redeemer lives. And I love that the Lord saved me, and I'm glad that He saved you too. But, you know, He saved us for something so much bigger than just ourselves. He saved us for a kingdom that is coming, and He's saving us as a people. So that's why we say, Hine Goalenu Chai. Can you say that with me? Hine Goalenu Chai. Oh, man, they got the happening over here. All right. So, anyways, that's the main phrase here. So when I say it, just do the echo for me if you don't mind.
Hine Goalenu Chai. Behold, our Redeemer lives. Yes, He does. Hine Goalenu Chai. Behold, our Redeemer lives. Let every tribe and tongue come worship Him. Let all the people learn His ways. Let us be gathered in Jerusalem, for these are the final days. These are the final days. Hine Goalenu Chai. Behold, our Redeemer lives.
Hallelujah!
Hine Goalenu Chai. Behold, our Redeemer lives. Let every tribe and tongue come worship Him. Let all the people learn His ways. Let us be gathered in Jerusalem, for these are the final days. These are the final days.
Yeah. Oh, He's coming soon.
Yes, Lord, You have promised. We will trust in You. Let every tribe and tongue come worship Him. Let all the people learn His ways. Let us be gathered in Jerusalem, for these are the final days. These are the final days. Hine Goalenu Chai. Behold, our Redeemer lives. Hine Goalenu Chai. Behold, our Redeemer lives. Let every tribe and tongue come worship Him. Let all the people learn His ways. Let us be gathered in Jerusalem, for these are the final days. 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 And you know that these are the final days. These are the final days. Hine go. Goalenu Chai. Our Redeemer lives.
Come on and shout it with me.
Our Redeemer lives.
One more time.
Our Redeemer lives.
Let Israel be glad in His Maker.
come and rejoice. Let Israel be glad in his maker. Let the sons of Zion rejoice in their king. Let them praise his name with dancing. Let them sing praises to him with timbrel and the lyre. For the Lord takes pleasure in his people, and he will bless the humble with Yeshua. Praise the Lord. Sing to the Lord a new song in the congregation of the righteous. Come and praise the Lord. Sing to the Lord a new song in the congregation of the righteous. Let the saints rejoice in his glory. Let them sing for joy on their beds. Let the high praises of God be in their mouth, and the two-edged sword in their hand. For the Lord takes pleasure in his people, and he will bless the humble with Yeshua. Praise the Lord. Sing to the Lord a new song in the congregation of the righteous. Come and praise the Lord. Sing to the Lord a new song in the congregation of the righteous. Yes, Lord, we come to rejoice in your presence tonight, oh God, and to exalt your name. Hallelujah. And declare your salvation. Let Israel be glad in his maker. Let the sons of Zion rejoice in their king. Let them praise his name with dancing. Let them sing praises to him with timbrel and the lyre. For the Lord takes pleasure in his people, and he will bless the humble with Yeshua. Praise the Lord. Sing to the Lord a new song in the congregation of the righteous. Come and praise the Lord. Sing to the Lord a new song in the congregation of the righteous. Come and praise the Lord. Sing to the Lord a new song in the congregation of the righteous. Oh, praise the Lord. Sing to the Lord a new song in the congregation of the righteous. In the congregation of the righteous. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord, we praise you, oh God. We praise you and we thank you, Father. You have called us out of darkness. So come and shine your light on Tacoma tonight.
Come, house of Jacob, let us walk in the light. Walk in the light. Walk in the light. Come, house of Jacob, let us walk in the light. Walk in the light of the Lord. Come, house of Jacob, let us walk in the light. Walk in the light. Walk in the light. Come, house of Jacob, let us walk in the light. Walk in the light of the Lord. The haughty man is humbled, the lofty one brought low. For the Lord alone will be exalted in that day, when every knee shall bow and every tongue confess that Yeshua is the Lord, unto the glory of God. Come, house of Jacob, let us walk in the light. Walk in the light, walk in the light. Come, house of Jacob, let us walk in the light. Walk in the light of the Lord. The pride of man is humbled, arrogance abased. For the Lord alone will be exalted in that day, when every knee shall bow, every tongue confess that Yeshua is the Lord, unto the glory of God. Come, house of Jacob, let us walk in the light. Walk in the light. Walk in the light. Come, house of Jacob, let us walk in the light. Walk in the light of the Lord. We're gonna walk. walk in the light.
Walk in the light.
Come on and walk, walk, walk. Walk in the light. Come, house of Jacob, let us walk in the light. Walk in the light. Walk in the light. Come, house of Jacob, let us walk in the light. Walk in the light of the Lord. We're gonna walk in the light of the Lord. Oh, come on and walk in the light of the Lord.
Does anyone bring a shofar tonight? Okay, well, I brought my own. They say the sound of the shofar is the very voice of God. And he's calling his people into an assembly and into a battle that we're going to get the victory. Come on, y'all, help me.
Away. Away.
Away.
On your strength, oh Zion, put on your beautiful garments, for Jerusalem, the holy city, shake off the dust and arise. Sing, O heavens, be joyful, O earth, and break out in singing, O mountains, for the Lord has comforted his people Israel, and he will have mercy on Zion. Awake, put on your strength, O Zion, put on your beautiful garments, O Jerusalem, the holy city, shake off the dust and arise. Lord, Tacoma is arising tonight. Awake, awake, put on your strength, O Zion, put on your beautiful garments, O Jerusalem, the holy city, shake off the dust and arise. Sing, O heavens, be joyful, O earth, and break out in singing, O mountains, for the Lord has comforted his people Israel, and he will have mercy on Zion. Your God, he will give an answer. Call on your God, he will answer you. When you call on your God, he will give an answer. Call on your God, and nothing will be impossible. Call on your God, he will give an answer. Call on your God, he will answer you. When you call on your God, he will give an answer. Call on your God. In that day, in that day will he answer you. In that day, in that day when you call on your God. Call on our God, he will give an answer. Call on our God, he will answer us. When we call on our God, he will give an answer. Call on our God. In that day, in that day will he answer us. In that day, in that day when we call on our God. Away!
Father, we're calling on you tonight. Lord, that you would send your spirit to Tacoma
around the world, oh God. Oh, sing, oh heavens, be joyful, oh earth, and break out in singing, oh mountains. For the Lord has comforted his people Israel, and he will have mercy on Zion. Away! Zion, awake!
Hallelujah! Yes, Lord, your people are awake. We say everything that has breath, come and praise the Lord. Praise him with the cymbals. Praise him with the dance. Praise him with the shofar. Come on, praise him with your hands. Praise him with the timbrel. Praise him with the harp. Praise him with the drum and the flute. And praise him with your heart. Hallelujah, Adonai. Hallelujah, Adonai. Hallelujah, Adonai. Come and praise the Lord. Hallelujah, Adonai. Hallelujah, Adonai. Hallelujah, Adonai. Come and praise the Lord. Oh, praise him with the cymbals. Praise him with the dance. Praise him with the shofar. Praise him with your hands. Oh, praise him with the timbrel. Praise him with the harp. Praise him with the drum and the flute. And praise him with your heart. Hallelujah, Adonai. Hallelujah, Adonai. Hallelujah, Adonai. Come and praise the Lord. Hallelujah, Adonai. Hallelujah, Adonai. Hallelujah, Adonai. Come and praise the Lord. And let everything that has breath come and praise the Lord. Lord, you are worthy of all honor and power and praise. We come to glorify the name Yeshua. The cymbals, praise him with the dance, praise him with the shofar, praise him with your hands. You better praise him with the timbrel, praise him with the harp, praise him with the drum and the flute, and praise him with your heart. Hallelujah, Adonai, hallelujah, Adonai, hallelujah, Adonai. Oh, come and praise the Lord. Hallelujah, Adonai. Hallelujah, Adonai. Hallelujah, Adonai. Come and praise the Lord. If you're thirsty, if you just need hope, oh, you can come and praise the Lord. Oh, come and praise the Lord. Hallelujah, Adonai. Hallelujah, Adonai. Hallelujah, Adonai. Come and praise the Lord. Come and praise the Lord. Come and praise the Lord. Oh, hallelujah. It is good to praise the Lord. This thing is ringing, I think. Let's enter into his gates with thanksgiving tonight.
Open to me, open to me, the gates of righteousness, Lord. Open open to me, open to me, open to me, the gates of righteousness, and I will go through them, and I will praise the Lord, and I will go through them, and I will praise the Lord. Open to me, open to me, open to me, the gates of righteousness, Lord. Open to me, open to me, open to me, the gates of righteousness. Help me sing it. Open to me, open to me, open to me, the gates of righteousness, Lord. Open to me, open to me, open to me, the gates of righteousness, and I will go through them, and I will praise the Lord, and I will go through them, and I will praise the Lord. Open to me, open to me, open to me, the gates of righteousness, Lord. Open to me, open to me, open to me, the gates of righteousness. Lord, open those gates. Your people are coming in. Come on, let me see some hands. We will go through the gates. The gates of righteousness. We're going through the gates now. To me, the gates of righteousness.
When I was 14, I was a little science nerd. I wanted to be a chemist. But then I heard Led Zeppelin. And there was something about the pounding drums and the screaming guitars that gave a 14-year-old aggressive boy pleasure. True, it is true. And so I really it was just the sounds that sort of drew me into a world that took me away. And so it was a couple of years ago, I saw this 12-year-old boy and he had a Led Zeppelin t-shirt on. And I said, did your daddy get that for you? Because I thought, you know, your dad should be ashamed of himself. And he says, no, man, I love Led Zeppelin. I said, you don't even know who they are. And he started naming off all my old favorite songs. And I thought, oh man, something's got to be done. So for one album, I tried an experiment. On the album Battle for Zion, I wanted it to be a sort of a prophetic statement. It's not meant to be praise and worship songs, but they are meant to sound cool. So I wrote a classic rock messianic album. So I'm going to do just a few of the songs from that one tonight. I'm not going to do the really heavier ones, but I'm going to do some. They're fun. They're good music. It's good to listen to, but it's not necessarily praise and worship kind of music that I would play. So I want to make that clear for us. Started?
Hey, Yeshua is the vine, and Israel a sign for all to see. Every tribe and tongue is grafted by the Son into the olive tree. And if casting them away, he received the world instead, then what is their return but life from the dead? I'm Echad, Adonai Echad, we are. God, we are one people, one God, one people. And in that day, God will take away all their sin. They shall be saved, and his servant David shall be their prince. In tears they have sown, but in joy shall they reap. He will lead them home as a shepherd leads his sheep.
Amen,
God. We are one people, one God. Amen,
God.
We are
one people,
one God. There is but one God. In the valley of dry bones, a holy wind is blowing, making noise. It's the sound of a nation, a holy congregation with one voice. They are singing a new song to their God, Shema Israel, Adonai Echad.
Amen, God.
We are
one people,
one God. With us, in him alone we trust for our peace. His love is forever and his mercy never will cease. And he will set his resting place in our midst, extending his love and grace to all who are here. We are one people.
Thank you very much. I would like to dedicate this next song to the United Nations. It comes from Psalm 121, verse 4. We'll do it in Hebrew and then we'll sing it in English. And it answers the question, what if King David had been from Texas? I think he'd have snapped his fingers, because we got nothing to worry about. Yeah. You're welcome to sing along.
Hine lo yadun ve'lo gisha, ve'lo gisha, ve'lo gisha. Hine lo yadun ve'lo gisha, shomer Yisrael. Hine lo yadun ve'lo gisha, ve'lo gisha, ve'lo gisha. Hine lo yadun ve'lo gisha, shomer Yisrael.
Now in English.
Behold, he neither slumbers nor sleeps, he who keeps Israel. Behold, he neither slumbers nor sleeps, he who keeps Israel. I wouldn't poke my finger in the eye of God if I were you. So if you're Hamas or Ahmadinejad, I got some bad news for you. Let me quote. Hine lo yanum ve'lo gisha, ve'lo gisha. Hine lo yanum ve'lo gisha, shomer Yisrael. Behold, he neither slumbers nor sleeps, he who keeps Yisrael. Behold, he neither slumbers nor sleeps, Israel. Behold, he neither slumbers nor sleeps, he who keeps Israel. Behold, he neither slumbers nor sleeps, he who keeps Israel. He who keeps Israel.
I'm glad you like that. How about some Messianic Motown? Anybody want to be the doo-wop girls? There you go. Just come on up. Some, ooh, ooh, ooh. It's easy. All right. All right, here we go.
In the twinkling of an eye, over dead shall rise. Israel shall see the Lord with blindness lifted from her eyes. With blindness lifted from her eyes. In that day, when the great shofar sounds, in that day, when the great shofar sounds, witness ever raise the sheep from the goats. Many will come from Washington, bringing honor to the King of Israel, the Master of Creation. He's the Master of Creation. In that day, when the great shofar sounds, great shofar sounds. Lord himself will descend from the heavens with the sound of the great shofar. Some may not sleep, but we shall all be changed when death is swallowed up in victory and victory. In that day, oh, I can hardly wait. In that day, in that day, and God's people shall be gathered. Our people stand upon sacred ground. No matter where we've been scattered, we shall be found. Yes, we shall be found in that day. Oh, when the great shofar sounds. In that day, when the great shofar sounds.
Well, so the whole time I'm producing that album, I had a whole lot of fun. It was a blast. But it, I don't know, it just felt like I was leaning a little bit too hard on this, you know, instead of this. And so for this newest CD, it's called Emergency. It's back there at the table. It's the only one that we have with us. I really thought that I wanted to do something more like what we really do in a Shabbat service. So I hired these four jazz musicians, and we went to a studio and just set up the mics. And, you know, just like we do on Shabbat, I just throw chord charts at them, and then we go out and we play it. And worship isn't meant to be rocket science. It's just simple, right? So these songs are a whole lot more, I think, authentic to the messianic style that I really write. So I hope you like them. Most of them are in Hebrew. This first one is Yom Zeh. Translate it before I sing it. This day unto Israel is light and gladness, a Sabbath of rest. I love the Sabbath, but I really get tired of playing Shabbat Shalom every week. So I wrote this Shabbat song for us.
Yom Zeh Li Yisrael. Yom Zeh Li Yisrael. Yom Zeh Li Yisrael. Ora Besimcha. Yom Zeh Li Yisrael. Ora Besimcha. Ora Besimcha. Shabbat Menucha, Yom Zeh Li Yisrael, Ora Besimcha. Shabbat Menucha, Shabbat Menucha. Hey! Yom Zeh Li Yisrael, Yom Zeh Li Yisrael, Yom Zeh Yisrael, Ora Besimcha. Yom Zeh Yisrael, Ora Besimcha. Ora Besimcha. Shabbat Menucha. Yom Zeh Yisrael, Ora Besimcha. Shabbat Menucha. Shabbat Menucha. Yom Zeh Yisrael, Yom Zeh Yisrael, Yom Zeh Yisrael, Ora Besimcha. Yom Zeh Yisrael, Ora Besimcha. Ora Besimcha. Shabbat Menucha. Yom Zeh Yisrael, Ora Besimcha. Shabbat Menucha. Shabbat Menucha.
Thank you.
En Kelohenu, en Kadonenu, en Kemalkenu, en Kemoshienu, mi Kelohenu, mi Kadonenu, mi Kemalkenu, mi Kemoshienu, no del Elohenu, no del Adonenu. No deli moshienu, Baruch Eloheinu, Baruch Adonainu, Baruch Malkeinu, Baruch Moshienu, Atahu Eloheinu, Atahu Adonainu, Atahu Malkeinu, Atahu Moshienu. Yeshua Eloheinu, Yeshua Adonainu, Yeshua Malkeinu, Yeshua Moshienu. Atahu Eloheinu, Atahu Adonainu, Atahu Malkeinu, Atahu Moshienu, Yeshua Eloheinu, Yeshua Adonainu, Yeshua Malkeinu, Yeshua Moshienu, Yeshua Eloheinu, Yeshua Adonainu, Yeshua Malkeinu, Yeshua Moshienu, Yeshua Moshienu, Yeshua.
Thank you. This next one comes from my favorite verses in the Bible. This one used to make me weep when I'd read it and I was trying to find something wrong with the Bible.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they that mourn, for God shall comfort them. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are those who thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. For behold, with the clouds of heaven, one like the Son of Man is coming. Rejoice and lift your head up to the sky, your redemption draweth Blessed are those who show mercy, for that is what they surely will receive. How blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see Elohim. Blessed are those who make peace, oh, they shall be called the children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness. For behold, with the clouds of heaven, one like the Son of Man is coming. Rejoice and lift your head up to the sky. Your redemption draweth nigh. Treated, for this is HaTorah et HaNevi'im. Rejoice and lift your head up to the sky. Your redemption draweth nigh. Blessed are you when men speak evil of you on account of Yeshua. For like the prophets before you, your reward in heaven is great. Behold, with the clouds of heaven, one like the Son of Man is coming. Rejoice and lift your head up to the sky. Your redemption draweth nigh. Your redemption draweth nigh. Your redemption draweth nigh.
Thank you.
The Lord, all ye nations, praise Him, all ye peoples, for His mercy and kindness are great toward us, and the truth of the Lord is forever. Oh, praise the Lord, all ye nations, praise Him, all ye peoples. For His mercy and kindness are great toward us, and the truth of the Lord is forever. In the courts of the Lord's house, in the midst of thee, O Jerusalem, I will offer to you a sacrifice of thanksgiving. Oh, praise the Lord, all ye nations. Praise Him, all ye peoples. For His mercy and kindness are great toward us, and the truth of the Lord is forever. Let those who fear the Lord now say, His loving kindness is everlasting. I will call upon His name and lift the cup of Yeshua. Of thee, O Jerusalem, I will offer to you a sacrifice of thanksgiving. Oh, praise the Lord, all ye nations. Praise him, all ye peoples, for his mercy and kindness are great toward us, and the truth of the Lord is forever. His mercy and kindness are great toward us, and the truth of the Lord is forever. Of Shavuot, you were the lily of the valley. Since the day that you were born, oh, rose of Shavuot, no little girl should ever have to see the things that you have known. You know the price of love. You paid the price of love. How can I explain when my worst nightmare couldn't compare to what you lived through every day? And just like a playground of blood and broken bones, you know the price of love. You paid the price of love. There came a day when they rescued you, and now you were free to run away. And when you were the judge and had every right to hate every one of them and make them pay, you paid the price of love. Oh, you know the price of love. And you said, Father, what they do. How could you do it? How do you do it, Rose? And where can I find that kind of mercy? Mercy, Rose. Showed me things about myself no one else could have ever shown. Oh, Rose of Sharon, you make the world a better place because you paid the price. La 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 la.
My daughter Charity. Charity was 11 years old when we recorded that. She's 14 now. That song is about a friend of mine named Rose Price. Rose was a Polish girl living in a little village when the German army came in. She was 11 years old when they took her and put her in a camp. She was 16 before she would get out. Charity still got a couple years to go. And I really shudder to think what would happen to a little girl like that in a German concentration camp. And like I mentioned before, when I got saved, I went to a Messianic congregation where both the rabbi and the cantor were children of Holocaust survivors. And, you know, it's interesting because I'm not Jewish or German, but I grew up loved history, you know, and I'd watch the History Channel, and I really liked all that old black and white footage from World War II. But the Holocaust was a long time ago, right? It's over. Well, I really didn't know it, but I had so many friends of mine who are still suffering from the pain of their families caused by something that happened 70 years ago. And how could I know it? You know, I wasn't attached to the Jewish community. So anyway, like I said, I travel all over the place. I go wherever I'm invited. And in May of 2006, I had been invited to Europe. And I went to Holland and Belgium, and I was having just this great time. But then I was also invited to a place called Tübingen, Germany. I didn't know anything about Tübingen, Germany, but I wondered, why would they want someone who plays Jewish music to go to Germany? And so I drove down there, and there's a big, huge white tent. Tübingen's right outside of Stuttgart. And I walked in the tent. The services are already underway. And the pastor immediately recognized me and asked me to come up and play a song. Hey, Mary. So I did. I walked up and I played one of my more obscure songs, a song called Road to Jerusalem. And as I started playing this song, about 500 Germans started singing it with me in perfect English. They were even doing the background vocals better than they are on the album. And I played just a couple more songs, but every song I played, they seemed to know every word by heart. I mean, they don't know me in Dallas that good, you know? I doubt my kids could do that. So I had a few questions for the pastor when I was finished. I said, Pastor, how is it everyone knows my songs? And he said, well, in the year 2000, we gave our church to 24-hour prayer. It's across the street, and we moved into this tent. And anytime, day or night, you can walk into that prayer tower, and there are people laid out all over the floor, and they're praying. And most of what we play is Messianic music, and our people seem to like your music the best. Thank you. Wow, what an honor. And I think maybe there's a lesson there, because I had no idea I was having any influence in Germany, you know. I think many of us sometimes think that, you know, we're insignificant and nobody's noticing, but somewhere you've touched somebody. And you may not get to see it like I did, but the Lord uses every one of us. So I was amazed by this, and I said, well, Pastor, you know, how is it you guys like Messianic Jewish music? And he began telling me this amazing story that really changed my life. But in the year 2000, they were praying and fasting and repenting for the sins of their fathers. And the Holy Spirit spoke to them and said, enough. You are just like your fathers. Well, they're ashamed of this. You know, I mean, the worst thing I could say about my dad is he was a womanizing drunk who liked to fight when he was young. But some of these people have mass murderers for fathers. And they were ashamed. As they should be. And they said, but Lord, we're not like our fathers. We have the Israel flag in our church. And the Lord spoke to them again and said, the sin of your fathers was their silence. And you know, that's really, the Nazis couldn't have done anything if there weren't people who just didn't say anything when their neighbors were taken away. If somebody would have just spoke up, out of 14,000 churches in Germany at the time, about 800 of them said something. You know, Germany produced more Christian theologians than any other nation in the 1930s. This is an amazing fact. And so this really cut them to the quick. And the Lord said they were silent. And so Pastor Bittner began studying what exactly is silence and how can we break this. And the people of this church began begging God, please show us how to break our silence. And Pastor Bittner came to the conclusion and showed me that silence is probably the worst sin of all. Silence is caused by fear or pain or shame. I've got a dear friend, Michael Lederer. Just a couple of years ago, he asked his mother, he says, Mom, you know, we came from Poland, right? I said, yeah. How is it we didn't lose anybody? I mean, how is it we were able to get out of there okay? And she says, you lost everyone except for two uncles. 57 years old, his mother had never told him this. It was too hard to talk about. And, you know, I meet a lot of people these days who say, you know what, I just found out my grandmother was Jewish. I just found out my dad was Jewish. And what it is it's fear. They're still afraid of being found out. They assimilate into the culture and they try to forget who they are. And so, in this church in Tübingen decided they were going to break the shame, the pain, and the fear. They were going to break the silence in Tübingen. They began asking the Lord, how can we break our silence? And the Lord directed them to go to the city square. Now, there are no Jews in the city of Tübingen in the year 2000. And the Lord directed them to go to the city square and to celebrate Hanukkah. And so they did. They went there, 230 of them, on Hanukkah, with a giant menorah they had built. And they didn't really know how to celebrate Hanukkah. So they just made this giant human Star of David, holding candles, you know. And it was an amazing seal that they put right there on the city square of Tübingen. And so the people of the city gathered around and their jaws were dropping. What is going on here? And from that point onward, they began doing what they called prophetic acts to break the silence. I really could go through a lot of different things they did. I think my favorite was the youth. The youth would bring a stepladder out to the city square, and one at a time, they'd get in a line, and one at a time, they'd climb that stepladder and just confess who their fathers were, what their fathers did. And they would say, but God wants to have mercy on those who will break their silence. And the people of the city began talking about things they had not mentioned in 70 years. And they began breaking their own silence in their families all over Tübingen. Jews began moving back to Tübingen. And they've changed so much now that after 1,500 years of anti-Semitic history, in the year 2008, Tübingen elected its first Jewish mayor.
There shall be a highway in the desert for the redeemed of the Lord. And from the mouth of the Lord of hosts shall go forth a fiery sword, and all the world will see Yeshua. And all the world will see salvation. And all the world will see Yeshua. And all the world will see that He is King. There shall be a fountain in the city to cleanse all the people from sin. And with the tree of life in the midst of her, for the healing of the nations. And all the world will see Yeshua. Yes, they will. And all the world will see salvation. And all the world will see Yeshua. And all the world will see that He is King.
Father, we know that You're coming soon. So
we lift up brothers, sisters, friends, mothers, fathers, children, that they would see you before that great and terrible day of the Lord.
And all the world will see Yeshua. And all the world will see salvation. And all the world will see Yeshua. And all the world will see He is King.
There shall be a sign in the heavens, and all the land will mourn for Him. When they look upon the one who was pierced, coming back to Jerusalem,
all the world will see Yeshua. And all the world will see salvation and power and glory. All the world will see Yeshua. See that He is King, and all the world will see Yeshua.
Come on and lift your voices.
And all the world will see salvation, and all the world will see Yeshua. And all the world will see that He is King.
Declare with your own lips,
Lord, You are King. He is King, and He's coming to reign in righteousness. Oh, He is King. He is King.
He is King. Hallelujah. Come on, give it up for the King.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We bless You, Lord.
All right. So I've got one more song. And like I always say, if you have any praise left in you, you don't want to bring it home. Come on. So we're going to shout and clap and rejoice that our God is faithful and He is watching over His people. And this is what He says to the nations.
Zion, I am zealous over Zion, zealous over Zion. I will dwell in Jerusalem. She shall be called the city of truth, the mountain of the Lord of hosts.
Ha ha,
for thus says the Lord, I will save my people. I am zealous over Zion, I am zealous over Zion. Are you zealous over Zion? I will dwell in Jerusalem. Old women and men shall sit in the streets, each one with a staff in their hand. The children will play in the streets of the city. Joy will be heard once again. I am zealous over Zion, I am zealous over Zion, zealous over Zion. I will dwell in Jerusalem. Kineti, let's see on. Kineti, let's see on. Kineti, let's see on. I will dwell in Jerusalem.
Somebody blow a shofar. Just as He promised,
They shall return from the east and the west to dwell in Jerusalem. They will be my people, for I am their God, in truth and in righteousness.
The sound of the shofar go forward.
Kineti, let's see yours. Kineti, let's see yours.
Father, strengthen my friends here in Washington, that we could reach every nation of this world. And we pray for your ancient chosen people, and that they would see Yeshua as he really is.
Kineti, let's see yours.
Shalom, y'all.
Thank you.